Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at using cutaways in iMovie. So I'm using iMovie version 10 and we're going to look at using cutaways. So cutaways are when you have one video, like here we have this one clip inside of my sample movie, and I want to cut away temporarily to something else. So let's select this second clip here, and instead of adding it to the end or the beginning, I'm going to add it on top. And what will happen is it basically automatically creates a cutaway where I start off with this one video and then it cuts away to this other video, which completely replaces it, and then when it's done it cuts right back. So you can do a lot to customize this. First thing you probably want to do is select the cutaway and maybe trim it a bit. So say I can reduce it there. I can drag either end like that so I can have a quicker cutaway. And now I want to have a nice transition. So I'm going to go to Adjust, and right here in the cutaway I can set a fade for a number of seconds. And if you notice, you can see the curve right there of the fade in and fade out. And I can actually drag the top there like that so I can set it. And now you've got it, instead of breaking right into it, you see it fade into the cutaway and then fade back. You could also make other adjustments, like for instance you can make the entire cutaway semi-transparent. So kind of in this case like more of a dream type of thing, but would make more sense in other instances. Now anything you use in a normal clip here, the main one in the timeline, you can use here. You can adjust the volume by dragging this up and down. You can use these color adjustments. You can use cropping. All sorts of things. Image stabilization. You can use audio effects. Everything that you put normally in here, even video effects, you could put inside of the cutaway. Now you can only have one cutaway at a time, but you can have a cutaway span more than one video. So let's take another video here and add it to the regular timeline down here, and you could see it can cut away to something. So fade into this, continue with the cutaway, and when it fades back, it fades back into this other video down here. Now you may have noticed the audio effect of lower volume of other clips, and this is where you really want to use that. If you have audio here and you want to fade from this, you want this volume to fade away, let this volume dominate, and then they return to the main volume afterwards. So you want to select that, lower the volume of other clips, and then you can adjust by how much. So this kind of does a lot of things for you. You could do manually by changing the sound curve. It will do them for you automatically just with this checkbox.